From anatomy to anesthesiology, from pathology to pharmacology, from microbiology to medicine, a one-man resource to the world of health sciences. Welcome to Dr. Paul's Medical Lectures. A practicing physician, Dr. Paul offers you essential insights on diseases afflicting millions of people around the world. For today's lecture, here is Dr. Paul.
Thanks. Scarlet purpura, basically abbreviated as HSP. So let's talk about Henoch scarlet purpura this morning. It's also known as anaphylactic purpura. Basically, it is a systemic vasculitis syndrome, and it is characterized by palpable purpura, most commonly distributed over buttocks and lower extremities. And they also have arthralgias, joint pains, and gastrointestinal signs and symptoms, and glomerulonephritis. So it's basically a small vessel vasculitis. It's a small vessel vasculitis. That's an important point. The disease is characterized by circulating tissue, immunoglobulin A, immune complexes, and it is ANCA negative. It's ANCA negative. That's an important point. So HSP is most commonly seen in children, and most of the patients, they range between 4 and 7 years of age. But however, even infants like younger than 4 years old or older patients or even adults are affected by this disease, even though it is rare in those groups. Now, let us talk about the basic incidence. The male to female ratio is like 1.5:1, and there is also seasonal variation with the peak incidence in spring. So many patients come in spring. The diagnosis of HSP, it's basically rests on the presence of typical maculopapular rash. So maculopapular rash, mostly on the dorsal surface of the lower extremities and buttocks. That's a very important clue. So maculopapular rash on buttocks, think of HSP. So it's a maculopapular rash present primarily, not exclusively, on the lower extremities and buttocks. And most children have abdominal pain and bloody diarrhea and joint pains depending on the extent of renal involvements. You see, some of these patients are affected by the kidney disease and they develop hypertension. And so renal involvement happens. It could be from mild glomerulonephritis to hematuria or extensive glomerulonephritis. So glomerulonephritis, it can present with the renal insufficiency and hematuria, proteinuria. So you see the wide range of organic involvement in this disease. Now let us talk about pathology. What basically happens in this disease? Basically, what is happening in this disease is immune complex deposition. That's one word you need to remember. Immune complex deposition. And patients will have this problem because of any number of inciting agents. They can develop this through drugs and foods and insect bites or vaccines. So they could be inciting, and IgA starts to deposit in these immune complexes. That's why in half of the patients, IgA levels are elevated in HSP. And if you take a renal biopsy, you will see the immune complex depositions. So that's about pathogenesis. What about the clinical manifestations? As I said, palpable purpura. In virtually all patients will have palpable purpura. And most patients develop polyarthralgias, and in the absence of frank arthritis, then gastrointestinal system involvement happens in about like 70% of our patients. And the gastrointestinal symptoms, they include colicky abdominal pain, and usually associated with the nausea. They will have vomitings. Some of them will have diarrhea. Some of them will have constipation. So gastrointestinal symptoms can present any number of these symptoms and signs. Sometimes they pass blood and mucus per rectum. The other important point is these patients have a risk for intussusception. So intussusception happens frequently in these patients. And what about the kidney involvement? As I said, mild glomerulonephritis leading to proteinuria and microscopic hematuria with red blood cell calves. So if you do a urinalysis in these patients, you will see red blood cell calves because glomerulonephritis has been happening in these patients. And rarely progressive glomerulonephritis will develop. Now, what about adults? In adults, the presenting symptoms most frequently related to the skin and joints. And many times you see these patients developing kidney problems. And the renal disease is more frequent actually and more severe in adults. But that's not a consistent finding. So many times you see patients, adults with HSP with kidney disease. And that could be more insidious and you need regular follow-up. And the other thing is heart involvement. Myocardial involvement occurs more frequently in adults with HSP than in children. That's an important point, folks. Myocardial involvement in HSP, it happens more in adults than in children. And what about the diagnosis? You see diagnostic tests. There are many diagnostic tests and all of them are non-specific. And diagnosis, basically, it depends on the clinical signs and symptoms. It's a very, very important part. So you need to take a careful history and do a careful physical examination. Because the diagnosis of Henoch's corneal purpura depends on clinical signs and symptoms. Of course, you can do skin biopsy to see that leukocytoclastic vasculitis. You can see IgA and C3 deposition by immunofluorescence. You can do a renal biopsy and see the focal glomerulonephritis or a mild glomerulonephritis, but all of them are not necessary if you take a careful history and a physical examination. Now let me talk a few things about prognosis. Prognosis of HSP is excellent. That's an important point to remember. The prognosis of HSP is excellent. Mortality is exceedingly rare. Only 1-5% of children progress to end-stage renal disease. So you see, most patients, they recover completely. And some do not even require treatment. Treatment, folks, is in adults, children. The same treatment is the same. It's glucocorticoid therapy. You do glucocorticoid like prednisone, and if you give prednisone, that suppresses that immune response and that reduces the symptoms and signs in these patients. And also the glucocorticoids, they reduce joint pains, the tissue edema, abdominal discomfort. So you see, glucocorticoids are the mainstay of treatment when treatment is required in these patients. Because glucocorticoids decreases the deposition of immune complexes and they also shorten the duration of the disease and they also helps preventing the recurrence of the disease. Especially patients who develop glomerulonephritis, they have a very good response to glucocorticoids combined with the cytotoxic drugs like cyclosporine A. And the disease recurrence is reported in 10-40% of patients. So 10-40% of patients can develop HSP again. So HSP is a systemic necrotizing vasculitis presented with leukocytoclastic purpura and arthralgias, gastrointestinal symptoms, and renal symptoms like focal glomerulonephritis. And it is very, very common. It can also present with sometimes with the lung problems, and the disease is characterized by circulating tissue, immunoglobulin A, IgA, immune complexes, and it is ANCA negative. So it's basically a small vessel vasculitis of the skin, gastrointestinal tract, kidneys, and patients will have purpura of the skin, especially buttocks, lower extremities. They will have colic abdominal pain, and also when the gastrointestinal system is affected, sometimes they develop gastrointestinal bleeding, and patient may come first with gastrointestinal bleeding and you wonder what is going on, and even before purpura, even before other symptoms, even before kidney symptoms. They present with gastrointestinal hemorrhage, and you wonder what is happening. Remember, always think of HSP when you see gastrointestinal bleeding, and in children between 4 and 7. And as I said, these patients have high risk of intussusception. Patients with HSP have a high risk of intussusception. Those are the most important points of HSP. Thank you very much. Please visit our website at www.drpaul.org, and also please feel free to post your comments on these websites. Thank you very much.
For more medical videos, please visit us at www.drpaul.org and take time to browse through hundreds of health videos we regularly post on our site. If you are preparing for USMLE, PLAB, and other medical exams, make sure you visit our website to browse through our videos explaining the essential points you need to know before taking these examinations. For more information, visit us at www.drpaul.org. Thank you, and may God richly bless you.